Yes, hello. Yeah, I hope that everybody hear me and can see me. So I'm here today to explain. There's the video.
This.
Do you hear me? Somebody hear me or not? Okay. So Ali, you hear Pavel? Okay. But some broadcast. Okay. Hello everybody. I hope that everybody hear me and can see me. Please, video spiral back. Okay, perfect. So I think that everybody can hear me and can see me. So thank you to join us today. I will explain you some aspects of Swiss law and try to answer all of your questions. So hi Nelly, hi everybody. We will start our presentation by Swiss company law. So also I will use the board that you can see on the right of my video. And here I will put some information that will be useful for you to understand better my presentation and answer your questions. So please don't hesitate to ask questions, because I think that it's better to make it on the way as it will be as much useful for you as possible. Just ask spontaneously, and even if it's not related to the topic that I'm talking about in the same moment, just ask question, and we will treat it later when maybe in the end, or when I will abort the subjects that you're asking about. So we'll start with Swiss company law. You know, everybody of us, I think, in some stage of the development, think to open a company. And Swiss company law is relatively similar to the company law of other European countries. So the forms that I will expose you today, they will be similar to the company forms that you can find in other countries, as in Greece, Poland, France, Italy, and other European countries. So, for example, in Switzerland, there are three main company forms. The first one is corporation limited by shares. Corporation limited by shares. The second one is limited liability company. So the abbreviation of the second one is LLC, and the abbreviation of the first one is corporation. And then the third one company is the most popular in Switzerland and within European Union. It's cooperative. It's says in French they say Société Coopérative, and in German it's Genossenschaft. Yeah. So between these three types of companies, the second one is the most used, because it's more easier and it's less expensive to create it. Within a few notable exceptions, the cooperative is nowadays rarely used. So there are not so many people who use the cooperative form in Switzerland also to conduct profit-driven commercial activities, as its capital and the governance structure are generally is suited to the type of activity. So cooperative company, cooperative form is mostly used for charitable activities. For example, for foundations that try to help some people, or maybe dogs or people that are homeless and so on. And people who want to do business, and for sure for startups, it's better to create the corporation and the LLC. Yeah. From moment to moment, I will check your comments and try to reply on it. No, you know, you should have the presentation of on the panel, on the white panel. So if you have no presentation, yeah, so I'm writing on the board, but I don't know why you don't have it. So maybe I will choose now another option. Oh, you see it. Okay, strange. Whiteboard. So everybody can see it? Okay, perfect. So wait, just a small configuration. Okay, so perfect. If everybody can see it, and if during my presentations there will be some problems with this whiteboard, please tell me and we'll find a solution. So as I told you, there are three types of company, and please, so let me know, what do you know? Do you know something about these companies, or already some businessmen that have created already companies? So I don't need to tell all details about these companies, or maybe there are people who don't know so much about different types. So I will expose the differences between them, and so that people can lead themselves to choose one or another. No idea about the differences. Okay, so I will expose the differences. So I will start with the limited corporation, limited by shares. Limited by shares. So I'll white the board and write the new one. Limited shares. So this is a type of company that is more useful for a startup. Yeah, of course. I will explain you which one is more useful for a startup. And the difference is, I will first start with the first one, with the corporation limited by shares. Then I will explain some details of the second one, the limitedly abilitated company. And then I will give you some figures that will allow you to decide by yourself which company is more useful for you, suits you better. So corporation limited by shares, it's a big company, you know, and it's the most expensive form, and the capital of this company. So you can create this company only if you have 100,000 Swiss francs. Go to startups to create the corporation limited by shares from the beginning. So you don't need in the beginning put this 100,000. You can start with the half of the sum, with the half. So you can put 50,000, but then your responsibility can be engaged till 100,000. So if you start your company just with the half of social capital, with 50,000, your debtors can sweat you for the another half. So if you are making the winding up, they can sweat you for the another half, still for 50,100. And this type of company is better maybe for a startup who have found already some investors who want to invest, who have money, and they just give it, and they want to take shares. Because when you create a company, when a person creates a company, he takes the shares. So a company is an independent entity that does not, it's an independent entity that is below to a person who detains shares of this company. For example, from when you're creating a company, a corporation limited by shares, while you are creating it, while you are giving this sum to the company, company gives you in exchange, it gives you back 100 shares, each one of value of 100, of 1,000, for example. And these shares give you the shareholders' rights. So when investors, when they give money to a startup, they take these shares in exchange. And then these investors, they have rights not to control directly the company, but they can ask, for example, for the accountancy, they can ask to have access to some internal documents and so on. And the person who is developing the business, as most of the time in this structure, named as director or, for example, administrator. So, so investors, I hope that you see my text. Please, please tell me if it's visible. Yeah. Investors take. Now see it. Okay, perfect. Take shares for in exchange of the capital. Exchange of the capital. So finally, when you invite investors to a project, you are not sure to have benefits of your activity. That's why you need all the time. So when you take money, when you take, for example, if you have no money at all and you catch some investor, you can give him maybe 40% of the capital of the shares of the company. Because if you will give him more than 50%, he will have the majority. So, and the person who has a majority in the company can do everything with it. He can dissolve it. He can change the director. He can change the employee. He can do whatever he wants. And of course, his power can be restricted. Yeah, can be restricted by the status of the company. Statue, company. So just to check the questions, but not now. What you write is visible with 3-4 minutes delay. Okay, it's not very good. Yeah, and the other question is 51%. Yes, if you give, don't ever give to anybody more than half of shares of your company, because then he have the majority and he can make all decisions by himself. And in the situation where you cannot refuse to give more than the half, you need to preview some security instruments in the statute of the company. For example, you can preview some important decisions for which the majority of the voting rights are not sufficient, for which, for example, they need to have 70% of the voting rights or 80% of the voting rights and so on. So that's the main points of the corporation limited by shares. So this organization, corporation limited by shares, is better for the companies, is better for the structures where people who are developing their business are not sole shareholders. So it's better for the structures when the people who are investing in this business are not developing it. So it's better for people it's better for structures where the investors and where the startups, people who develop it. Yeah. So, do you have some questions about this? Stretch after writing the text. Okay, I will put enter. Okay, so I hope that by fact, by putting enter after I'm writing the text, it will help, but I'm not sure. So I hope that you see the text. And the second corporate form, I will make now a new list. Yeah, I will make a new list and a new text. And now I will explain you some details of the limited liability company. Company. Please tell me, do you see the text now or not? So I did not get your reply. If you see the text, no, you don't see the text. And now? Yes, okay, perfect. So I think that, okay, I will do like this. So the second form of the company, of the most popular and the most used company is the limited liability company. To create it, you need to have just 20,000 Swiss francs. And then in exchange for of these 20,000, when you are giving these 20,000 of Swiss francs to the company, you get parts of this company. Shareholders parts. I think that there are some special name, but the meaning is the same. It's shareholder parts. And the difference of this company is that people who create it, they have the right to represent it. So the difference of this company is that all people who create this company, they have the right directly to represent it. So this type of the company is more used by people who want to develop it. For example, for people, for groups of people who unite themselves in order to develop it. Yep. So. Do you have any experience with companies, maybe limited liability company or the previous company that I just explained? Please tell me. The corporation limited by shares. Oh, perfect. So Zoran, I see your question. Can I create a startup from my project from Serbia? Okay. Now, yes. So Zoran are asking us if he can create a startup for my company, for his project in Serbia. Of course, you can create a company in the European Union or in Switzerland, but it's not sure that they will give you the residence permit in Switzerland. So I will explain this subject a little bit later. Okay, so I think that not to complicate the things, I can tell that the limited liability company is better for people, for a group of people, for example, for three or four person who want to associate themselves and to develop their business. And the corporation limited by shares is better already for big companies who have investors eventually, or who have people who investors, yeah, like people give money to the company and they don't want to develop it. So that's the main difference between these these two companies. And the limited liability company is also easier to organize it, because the first one is it's more difficult, and it takes much time to organize the shareholders meetings. You need all the time to take notes. Also, the creation is more expensive. Okay. So thank you, Steve, for your question. I will answer on it. You know, when you each as a company is an independent entity, it should be represented all the time by somebody, because company by itself cannot react, cannot sign documents, cannot go to talk with somebody, cannot make contracts, and all the time companies, they need some representatives. And by default, representatives of the company are they administrators or they directors. Yeah? And in the case of the limited liability company, all partners who created, they became by default directors of this company. And by default, they became representatives of this company. So it's better for limited liability company is better for startups, because all of them, by default, they become representatives of the company, because they're developing business, and the representation quality is important to them to in order to develop it. And in the case of corporation that I described in the beginning, not all participators in the creation, they obtain the representation quality. For example, investor, they have no representation quality. And even sometimes some people who have the representation quality, for example, director or administrator, who are who are developing this business and who are startups in the fact, they can refuse to give some information to the investors. They can just tell that, listen, it's a secret, and we cannot give you the access to some information. So I hope that I answered to your question. And do you mean that in LLC, all co-founders can sign the contract on behalf of... Yes, by default. So when you don't make a contrary provision in the statute of the company, by default, all participants in the LLC, they can sign contracts on the name of the company. But you can make a different configuration. But it is the regime by default is that they can all sign on the name of the company. Yeah. And in the first one, in the corporation limited by shares, only director and administrator can sign. And investors who give money, they have no right to sign contract and no right to represent the company and no right to engage the company by default. But of course, you can preview otherwise in the statute of the company, and you can give rights to the investors and withdraw representation rights from the partners. Yeah. I hope that I explained, answered this question. Email address. Okay, I will give you email address later. Okay, do you have any other questions concerning the difference between limited liability company and corporation limited by shares? Yeah, okay, great. Okay, so now I will go to the second part. It's... I described to you now the difference between these two main forms of the companies, and now we'll pass to the second point of our presentation. It is how finally we can establish a company in European Union, for example, or in Switzerland, being a citizen of a non-European country, because you know there are a lot of restrictions how to come here in Switzerland to European Union from Russia or from Serbia or from I don't know, from Asia, from China, and so on. So I will try to put you a presentation now. So upload a presentation, and it will not take a lot of time. Join Grant Webinar Doc. Okay. Okay, it's converted now, so I will start already. Do you have any experience, maybe, have you ever worked in the European Union, or do you have any experience in creating companies in the European Union? Please let me know, just try to participate, you know, because I think that to be more useful for you, I need to know what do you need. So just direct my speech, ask me some questions, because even if you will ask me some questions that are not in the plan today, I can answer, so it will be most useful for you. So presentation is still not there, but I will start already. So no experience, it was my next question. The topic is mean reason I'm here. Okay, perfect. I will so tell you everything. Worked but never had a company. Okay, so now I will explain how you can create your company, and by creating your company, obtain also a residence permit to live in Switzerland. Or I think that the legislation is relatively the same in other European countries. Maybe even in other European countries, it's more easier than in Switzerland, because in Switzerland, the actual politic is to eliminate as much as possible the foreigners here, and not to get him enter. But I will tell you everything so that you will be able to create a company and come here. Who want to become self-employed in Switzerland need to meet the Swiss labor market requirements that are listed in the Federal Act on Foreign Nationals, decrees, and so on. Only holders, for example, if you even have a residence permit in Switzerland and you are working for a company, you still cannot work for yourself. For example, if you are working, you know, for Philip Morris here or for one other big company, you still cannot work for yourself, because your residence permit is still attached to your employer. And only holders of a valid and spouse of the holders of C permit can work in Switzerland, and all other people cannot work on themselves. So still not coming. Okay, so everything is starting by creating a business plan, of course. Yeah, you need to write a business plan, and then decide in which country you need to create the company. For example, if you choose Switzerland, you, after writing a business plan, you maybe consult a jurist so that he can advise you the form of the company that is more useful for you. For example, we give this service. You can we can advise you also in our legal advice office, and then when you created already a company, it's not sure still that you can come here and work for yourself. You need to fill in certain conditions that I will now expose to you. So here it's not working. I will go to the another whiteboard. Okay, perfect. So I will make it here. Conditions. I hope that you see my whiteboard. Okay. What are the conditions in order to get the residence permit? The conditions are following. So the company, For example, your company, if you are creating a company, it should be useful for the local authorities, useful for local people, usefulness for local, okay, usefulness for local. So you need to be useful. You can not come just and open some heavy industries that will pollute the surroundings, and to open, I don't know, some commerce that make concurrence to the local commerçants, and to open a kiosk, to open some other small business, maybe to make some water. It's not possible. So to get a residence permit by opening a company, you need to create some useful business for Switzerland, yeah, and useful business for region. For example, in the region where I'm living now, it's in Lausanne, the useful business is considered as, for example, touristic field. It's also considered as, touristic field. For example, high technology field, developing new products, internet field, also communication field, and they don't like at all fields that pollute air and that makes the condition of life is worse here. Yeah. And appreciation of these conditions, they check if there are already a lot of people who are doing the same. For example, if you are coming here and you have the education of architect and you want to create some private school, they will check first because they're interested to invite people who are creating like some value as private schools here, but they will check if there are some concurrence about it. And if they will find out that there are a lot of people already who are created private schools, does not allow you to do it. They will allow you to create the company, yeah, because they cannot restrict this, but they will not give you the residence permit for this. So where you can find those fields? Okay, I know one co-working place who is working especially in the fields that are considered as useful for the local people. I will just write you the name now. And in the beginning, in the top of this website, you can see the fields of business that this co-working place accept to their premises. Wait a moment. Bettercoworking.ch. Okay, so just go to this website and check the bottom of the website and check the fields that they encourage in this co-working place. And it is the same fields that are encouraged by the government. Then, do you have other questions? Yes, I see the conditions. Swiss suppose. Okay. Family reason. If you have a B residence permit for family reasons, you can make an independent activity. Yeah, for sure. Okay. Okay. So, the second condition is that the financial and another conditions related to the establishment of the company should be fulfilled. So I will write it down. Conditions for the company establishment. Okay, so this is the second condition. It's relatively easy to fulfill it because as soon as you have your company already registered in the Chamber of Commerce, it's in internet, you can consult the inscriptions of all companies in Switzerland on the following website. I will just give it to you. So on this website, you can just go and check the registration of all companies in Switzerland, cfix.ch. Yep. this one. Yep. And as soon as your company is registered on this website, is as soon as it's visible here, you can this condition, the second condition, is fulfilled. And no, it's not so easy. Also, then after your company is registered on this website, you also need to fulfill some specific conditions in order to do your business. For example, if you want to make some products or some beverages, you need to fulfill some conditions about the food industry. Or for example, if you want to do some restaurant, or not some restaurants, not interesting for the local people, but if you want to do some production, yeah, you want to produce watches, for example, it's very popular in Switzerland, you need to fulfill a lot of conditions, case on a lot of conditions that are relative to your business space, to your office, so to your production office. There will be some firemen who will come, who will check that the conditions of the usefulness of this building are good, and there will be some medicine who will come and to check if you have some first aid medicine pocket and so on. So that's the second condition. So the second condition is that the condition of that all conditions to do a business are fulfilled. It can be registration of the company, it can be exploitation of your business, some license, and so on. Do you have some questions about it? Co-working. Okay. Just write me your questions, and I will answer everything. Okay, so the condition is it's very important conditions. It's quota. It's called quota. Yeah, it's a quota. Quota. So I will write you down this one. Yeah, it's quota. So this means that federal authorities, they give a number of places for each canton. Switzerland is separated for 25 or 26 cantons. Yeah, it's like a federal republic like Russia, which is also splitted on 24 parts. I don't know how many parts in Russia there are, but Switzerland is splitted on 25, 26 parts. And for each region, which are called canton in Switzerland, federal authorities give a limited number of places for foreigners. For example, to Canton de Vaud, where we are living, they give only 120 places per year. So the local authorities, the authorities of the Canton de Vaud, cannot accept more than 120 person per year from non-European countries. They cannot accept more than 120 persons without European nationality. It's called quota. But local authorities, they found also a solution for this problem, because they can deliver short-term residence permit without quota. So for short-term, it's 6 months. And when they have some candidate who fulfill all conditions to obtain a residence permit for 1 year, but they have no more quota for this year because this person, he asked for the residence permit in November or maybe in December, and they have just no more places because they used all of them already during this year. They can give him in the beginning a short-term residence permit that is called it's F, I think, it's short-term residence permit. And till the it will be valid till the next year. And in the beginning of the next year, as they will get one more quota, one more 120 places from federal government, they will give him a normal valid residence permit for 1 year. No, they're just, yeah, they're just something like 120 places for war. Yeah. Yeah. Just not 120,000, but 120 places. And yeah, it's the quota for this kind of activity, but there are also a lot of, there are some another ways to bring foreign people here. For example, big companies as Nestle, Roche, as Tobacco, American British Tobacco, and other big companies, they don't get residence permits by this way, but they have another procedure. It's called inter exchange or something like this. They just bring people from the representations of their companies that are abroad. For example, they can British American Tobacco, they can bring some person from their office from Ukraine here to Switzerland for temporary duration for 1-2 years, and then they need to send them back. But for this kind of procedure, they give just 120 places per year. Yeah. So the next condition. Yeah. The candidate should leave local authorities think that so he need to have following private yeah hi he need to have following private qualities. Yeah. Private quality. So I will note it to you. Private. Personal. Yeah. So it's personal qualities. Okay, so he need also to have, yeah, he need also to have some personal qualities. And what are those personal qualities? So the first one is that he need to think, he need to leave local authorities think that himself to the local environment, so that he will not do some crimes, that he will just live normal life and be normal liver. Yeah. And then he need also to have equivalent experience and education. For example, a person who want to open a private school or some other business that are encouraged by the local authorities, for example, some internet new product, I don't know, maybe some or he's writing some script for a new program. He want to invent some new program. He need to have equivalent experience and equivalent education. For example, for this person who is writing a script, he should have education of informatic guy. Yeah, and he need to have also this experience and to appreciate the quality of the candidate. Local authorities, they have tables, so for each qualification, for each profession, they have precise number of asked years of experience and years of education. It could be 3 years of experience in some company and 5 years of education. And person who apply for the residence permit, he need to show that he need to show papers, he need to show some documents from university and from his employer. Yeah. We'll just check your questions. So don't forget, please, to ask questions if something is not clear. Yep, I will continue. So, personal qualities. I explained already two personal qualities. It's education and experience. It's the first one. The second one is that he will integrate himself well. And the exception to these personal qualities can be the fact that the person who are coming, who want to come, will create new job places, workplaces. Yeah? Or he will invest to some fields that encourage. So if you can create three or four workplaces, you don't need to fulfill personal qualities. They don't care about it. Just create three, four workplaces and they will give you the residence permit. So it's what was about personal qualities. Yeah. And the last one is that the candidate should have a flat, you know, he should have a place to live. So when you apply for the residence permit, you need to show that you fulfill all these conditions and to show that you have also a flat, so you can join your bill, not bill, but a contract, residence contract for a flat. Yep. So we have a question. I'm a PhD assistant in the PFL and I'm willing to have a startup on my project. Do I fulfill these personal qualities? Okay. In order to answer you this question, so let's check personal qualities. The first personal quality condition is that you should have appropriate education and appropriate experience. So it's experience. I will write it to you to the chat. Experience plus education. Yeah. And then, you know, we can check also, you can come to our legal advice office and we will check in these tables if your precise number of years of education and experience, they fulfill the condition to get the residence permit. The second one is that you adequate, if we can tell like this, adequate for the integration. It's the second condition. And the third one is experience. Not experience, the exception. If you will create workplaces or you will invest them to the fields that are interesting for the local authorities, you don't need to fulfill these two conditions. For the work places or investment. Okay, so like this you have also speak French C1 and German. You know, for this procedure they don't ask for the language skills. Yeah, it's also good to speak it, but when you are coming you are not supposed to speak directly. For this procedure they don't ask to speak some language, but it's also a plus. So it's good. It's something very good. It will help you to get maybe the C type residence permit later, and like this. So that's what was about. Make a screenshot. I don't know something because I will erase now this this white table, and because I will show you some other conditions. Yeah. So now I will show you the example of the person who is living, for example, in Russia and who want to come finally to Switzerland because it's too boring for him in Russia and he want to open a business in Switzerland and come here. And we will check this procedure from the formal way. So we will a little bit check it. I will tell you what the person do need to do. To get here. Yeah. So first one. You already erased. Yes, sorry. It's possible to guarantee that they give a permit for startup funder. No, you know there are no warranty that they will give it, but because you have no right to get it, but you can request it. You can request it, and but you cannot claim it. You can just request it. But if the conditions are fulfilled, I think that there are no reasons that they refuse it. And for sure, if the field will be interesting for the local authorities, and as you are from EPFL, I think that you can write some new programs. And for this field, it's easier to get some authorizations because they try to encourage everything that are related to the new technologies and to the new products also. So for people from EPFL, it's relatively easy. And you know, also it's easier because after EPFL, because also it's a state school and it's relatively known in Switzerland and abroad also. So the formal conditions, finally, what do we need to, so it's very interesting, I think, for you to get all these material conditions. So we need to fulfill this, and then maybe we can get something. But what should we do to get here? What should we do? So the first step is to go to the embassy, to the place where you're living, and to tell them that you have a business plan. You have a business plan and you want to develop Switzerland economy and you want to get here. So the first step is to go to the embassy. Go to the embassy. Okay, so here you have it. Okay. The second one. So in the embassy you will get the forms and so on. They will give you a pack of paper to fill in, and you need to fill this in, everything. And in the same time, while you're deposing your request to the embassy, you need somebody in Switzerland who will already create the company. Who will maybe not create it, but who will prepare everything in order to create it. Because in your application form, which you give to the embassy in Russia, for example, in the embassy where you live in, you need to give all papers that will prove that you have already a business plan, that you have already some partners in Switzerland, maybe abroad, if your business will be directed to other countries, if you will work with Spain or with Italy. Register. Okay, so I have one more question. I will reply it just in 5 minutes. And you need to have a lot of documents. It's, for example, I have somewhere a list. Yeah, you need to have for example, your photo of passport photo with you. You need to have your passport, of course. You need to have your CV with you, curriculum vitae with you. So the paper where you describe all your competencies. Else, you need to have the copies of your diploma, your work certificates, your motivational letter. And if you are opening the company, you need also to have a pack of papers that will prove that your project is already relatively developed, that you've made already everything that we can attend from you to develop it, and that you already engaged some procedure to open a company. Maybe you did not open it already, but you have already all papers prepared. So it should be a huge dossier. Yeah. So, requested. Yeah. So you need to act in the place where you live in, and in the same time in the place where you want to go. For example, in Switzerland, you need to have somebody here on place who will prepare documents in order to open a company. And all these documents you need to leave in the embassy where you live. And then the embassy, your local embassy, they will send the request to the immigration authorities on the place where you plan to open your company. And the immigration authorities, they will consult also labor authorities. They will think if it's useful, if your field is interesting for the local authorities or not. And after they have a decision, they transfer this dossier to the federal immigration authority. Federal immigration authority takes the final decision, and after approval or maybe a rejection, they transfer it to the local immigration authority, and finally local immigration authority gives the answer to the embassy. The whole procedure can take from, I think, 4 to 6 months, something like this. And even if it's some complicated case, it can take 1 year or even more. But the minimum, I think it's 3 months. So you can do nothing before 3 months. Yeah. So this is the procedure. And maybe I forget to tell you some documents. So it's the procedure to open your own company. I'll also write you a small text. So it's given then a procedure local migration, and then transfer it to general migration. Federal migration, and then transfer it to the embassy. Okay, I hope that you can see my screen. So first you have the embassy, you give your request to the embassy. Embassy give it to the local migration office, and local migration office give it to the federal migration office, and then embassy get back the reply. So I have some questions now. We'll try to reply on it. Is it possible to guarantee that they give a permit for startup founder? No, it's not possible, but I think that if conditions are fulfilled, you will get it. Because they're interested to develop the economy, they're interested to develop fields that they are interested in. The second one is, you already raised, I have the new one. What documents we need to register a startup? Do we need to have a lawyer, or we can do it by ourselves? So the reply is that to register a startup, so I will erase now in 1 minute my screen with description of the procedure in order to answer this question. So in the beginning I will try to ask it orally. In order to register a startup, I think you need to register a company. Just tell me what is the objective to register this startup? Because you know, in the beginning you can even work without company. If the objective is to get a residence permit, I think that it's better to register the company. So can I have this precision? Okay, I have no precision, so I will tell you what it's necessary to register the company. So to register the company, it's necessary to have a passport. It's necessary to have a money. So you need to have for a limited liability company, LLC. It's something like 3,100, and you need to have 20,000 of capital. Capital that you can use after. So I wrote a new screen. So you need to have a passport, your valid passport. You need to have 3,100 Swiss francs in order to open the company, and you need to have 20,000 of capital. And also you need to have a local director. and office place. But you can also make the office place at home. Home possible, but not serious. And if you are living in Switzerland, you don't need local director. For example, if you are studying in EPFL and you are living in Switzerland in permanent basis, you don't need the director. You can be the director yourself, but then you need to request local migration authority for the authorization to exercise private activity, to exercise independent activity. Okay, I hope that I answered this question. Steve, thank you for the question. You need to marry a Swiss girl if you want to get Swiss permit. Yeah, it's the best way because, no, it's the easiest. It's maybe not the best, but the easiest. And because if you marry some Swiss person, you will get the passport in 3 years. So it's the easiest. It's the easiest way for sure. And the last question, Lena Gore. Hi, Pavel. How to provide payments before incorporate startup? How to provide payments before incorporate startup? We need to have trial deals, but we don't want to register a limited companies. So can you just explain what do you mean by trial deals? Trial deals. Trial deals. Ah, okay. So I see. It's like trial deals. Yeah. To try. So. Yeah, of course. You don't need by incorporation of startup. You mean, I think, creation of a company. And it's not necessary to create a company to make deals. Of course, if your partners, they consider you seriously without company. And for example, personally, I had a lot of business in Switzerland and abroad. And in the beginning, I had no company. Then I worked as a sole proprietorship. Yeah, I had a sole proprietorship. It's the easiest easiest type of the company when you are just alone, you are working for yourself. I was working from home, and then I migrated my not migrated. I created a what is the name? A corporation limited by shares. Yeah, it was 3 years ago. But in the beginning, I was working without any company. Thank you, Pavel. Yeah, you are welcome. Just tell me if you have other questions, and now we will go to the. To the next topic. So the next topic is few words about example Ivan want to move to Switzerland. So few words about cross-border mergers, division in the moving of the companies. So for example, if you have a company in Poland or you have a company is in Serbia or even in Russia, in England, for example, now there will be a lot of companies who will move from England to Europe, because England is going out from European Union. So the fact, the interesting thing is that you can move your companies. So if you have a company in Poland, you can move it to Switzerland, and there are different ways to do it. You can make it all by winding up your company, your original company, and by creating the new one. But it's not the best way to do it because you lose your shareholdership. So you shareholders, they liquidate the company, they get money for the liquidation, and then they need to create the new one, and also they spend money. And in European Union, there are some instruments that help to migrate companies without winding it up, without dissolving it, if I can say like this. But those instruments are not perfect, and it's they are not perfect because to only one social form of society can be migrated without any problems. So it's I'll write it to you. It's European society. European company. It's a special type of company which was created by European Union legislation. It's a European company. Some people, they call this form as not European company, but European society. And this form allow shareholders and directors to move it from one country to another, like a company that can be moved from one place to another. And the normal companies, they cannot migrate without winding up, without dissolving it, and without fusion, and without eventually separation. For example, you can have one company and then split it into two, and one company you can remain in the origin country and another one to move somewhere. So do we have questions? Hope I cannot see questions. Thank you, Pavel. Yeah, please let me know. I think that maybe this is not the most interesting topic for you. Just let me know if there are some other questions that will be more useful for you. I will just try to reply directly. So now we exposed already the cross-border migration of the companies. And there are also one aspect of migration law that I would like to expose you today. It's how to come to European Union, or for example Switzerland, without creating a company. I'll just open a new file so that I can write on it. Presentation. Okay, I have it. I will try to write. It's not working, so I need to go to another one. This one I will close. Whiteboard. Yeah, perfect. Whiteboard is working. I will write this one and will expose you the next one. So how you can, so you can come also to Europe or to Switzerland as an employee. So you can come to employee. And but to come for employee, you need also to fulfill several conditions. It's the first one is that you need to be your employer need to make everything that depends on him to try to find a right employee here in Switzerland and in the European Union before inviting you. So he need to try to find local employee. Try employee. Try to find a local employee. Yeah, and then just after he cannot find a local employee, he can invite somebody from abroad. And the second condition is that the person that he invites should be experienced and experienced and educated for the type of job that he is invited. For example, if you are invited for a company that are writing some new scripts, you need to be have an informatic education and some informatic experience. And for example, if there are some company who need some people who speak Indian language, they need to explain why they need this kind of people, and maybe they want to develop some Indian market, and that's why they need to invite some people from India. So they need to explain why they need some special skills, and they need also to explain that the person that they are inviting have these special skills. So we have some questions there. Hope. Okay. What about no disclosure agreements? Mikhail is asking us, do we need to sign them every time? So no disclosure agreement, I think that yes, it's better to sign it, but only if you give some sensible information to somebody. For example, now we are hiring new people in our company, and during the trial period, we give them information that we don't want them to disclose it, that we don't want to tell them it to somebody, and to encourage them to speak about it on their free time, we preview the conventional pain. So sorry, I will translate it just from French. Pain conventionnel. Yeah, and it's better to preview in this type of agreements a conventional penalty. So like these people who sign, they will consider it more seriously. For example, you can preview in the no disclosure agreement a conventional penalty of 10,000 Swiss francs. Like this person who signed it, he will consider it really seriously, and I think that it will discourage him to. That it will discourage him to disclose any information about your business or about you. Then Mikhail is also asking us, what about further document needed to run business? Further document, okay. So to run business. Yeah, to run business, I think that you need you need just documents that are necessary for your clients to be confident in you. Just documents that needed to your clients to be sure that you will deliver them good services. For example, it's not necessary to give to have. Of course, if you have some sensible business, you need to get state authorization to explode. To explode it, for example, you need to have authorization of firemen to have a big building with some gas station and so on. But to make some informatic works, so you don't need special authorization. You can just work in the beginning by yourself, for yourself, but you need to declare your revenue to the local tax authorities. And if you are a foreigner, you need to request for the authorization that will allow you to work for yourself, to make some independent activities that will bring you some revenue. So that's, yeah, it's not, you know, in Switzerland they are not so they don't restrict business so much. You can do whatever you want, for of course in normal circumstances, but also pay attention, for example, for the taxes and for the social security. If you start some work for yourself as an independent person, you need to pay AVS. It's assurance invalidité. No, it's assurance vieillesse et survivance. It's insurance that allow you to get some money when you are old. So you need to give some money now to the state, and the state will give you some money later. Next question, of your own company. Okay, yeah, it's the next question. How you can get authorization while you're working for your own company, not as an investor, not by creating the workplaces, but as your own company. That's what I was talking about. So to get authorization as employee, we can go back to the white field and to check what I wrote already. So to get authorization as employee, you need to, the employer, the person who invites you from abroad, he need to try to find a local employee with the necessary skills. And only if he cannot find it, he can invite somebody or take somebody from abroad, from no European country and no Switzerland. Then this candidate should be experienced and educated. Experienced and educated. As I told before in the previous procedure, experience, number of years of experience and number of years of education, they are prescribed by the tables, special tables that government use for these reasons. So then, or as I explained before, here it's applicable it's relevant also. So you need to have personal qualities. So now qualities. Yeah. You should be somebody who will make think local authorities that you will integrate yourself in the local society. Quality. Yeah. And then just let me think one more second. I will tell you another conditions. This one. Experience and try to. Okay. Person quality. Yeah, and the flat. But the flat, it's not so easy to find the flat, but it's not so difficult to fulfill. For example, you can be domicilized in your friend's place, or in this case, he need to establish you some documents that you are living with him. Okay, so check just the questions. Without sir, yeah, it's a very good question. Employee. About Steve Petkovich. Yes, thank you, Steve, for your questions. About employees. Can you please tell us about how to hire people for work for equity, but not for salary? Yeah. Of course, I can explain you. Okay. So how to hire the people? We have the encouragement plan. Okay. Incentive plan. So it's called insensitive company insensitive plan. So I'm filling the whiteboard. Yeah. To make people work with you and don't pay them salary, you need to find people who believe in your project, and it's very important to do. And while you find people like this, it's a great deal. Yeah. And of course, startups in the beginning, they have no money, so they need to work to make work people even without money, and it's a great deal. I think that it's the motion, not the motion, but the impulse, momentum. Yeah, it's you need to create momentum, and then people will go behind you even without any money. So. Company insensitive plan, it can help to create this momentum by promising people shares, parts of your company on the place of the salary. So you can make a contract. For example, if you have in the case of limited liability company. Yeah? In the case of limited liability company, you have 20 shares, you have 20 parts. You give 20,000 and you get 20 parts. Each part for 1,000. And if you have no money in the beginning, you can make a contract with your friend or maybe with your partner, with your future partner, accordingly to which you will give him for 1 year. I don't know how. Yeah, maybe 10 parts. Not more than the half, not half, because if you give him half, you need to think all the time what he will vote during the general meeting, and it's better not to give him more. Never give more than the half, and don't give half. So you need to give him less than half. So give him for 1 year work. Give him not 9 parts. Parts. It will be 9,000. Yeah. Okay, like this. Yeah. And if you find person like this, it's very good. I think that if your project is already relatively developed, you can find people that will follow you, and even you can change. If your project is relatively developed, you can trade maybe one part, 3 months work. Or you can maybe split, you can pay something to him. Or you can, yeah, you can make another configuration. But you can get more information in internet about this this type of remuneration of work with this with the keyword company insensitive plan. It's very useful. I think that it's very important to motivate people in your company. Then the next question, I think that I answered you. Please let me know if you have other questions. About employees, can you please tell us about how to get people? Okay. And then, and can we legally hire people without salary? Yeah. How can we hire people without salary? Yes, we can hire them without salary, but not in all fields. For example, if you are working in legal field, yeah, you can hire people without salary. You can just preview with them that they will work. You can take some trainees, not Chinese, internship. You can take some trainee, yeah, for the price, not the price, the salary of a trainee is 500 Swiss francs, yeah. And then you can hire also an experienced person for 100 if he accept to work for it. And there are some fields that are restricted. There are some fields where government take care about people and don't allow to hire people for low salaries. For example, it's cleaning services, it's domestic personnel, it's maybe some other fields where employee is in a deferable position. In unfavorable position, where employee is weak and he needs some protection. But in the most of field, there are no protection, and you can just you can just preview with the person salary as you want. So we have one more question. Could you be founder of the company? You can be founder of company and invite yourself by your general director to work as, yes, it's possible. So you can be a founder and as a shareholder of the company, and you can be invited to the same company. Yeah, it's possible. So there are two procedures. In the first one, you can come as the founder of the company, just the founder of the company, and you can become the director of your own company by yourself and make I call this procedure investor procedure. So person who have money, he come and he create maybe 2 or 3 workplaces, and he becomes the director, the administrator of this company, and he gets the residence permit of this on this base. And the second procedure is that you come as an employee of the company. And this company, it can belong to yourself also. It's not a problem. What about taxes for people work for shares? That's a very good question, and it's difficult to reply it just directly. So I'll try to expose it on this whiteboard. For example, if you have a person who is working 6 months for 5 parts, and these parts price on 02/2017. It's so we gave him 5 parts. It's 5,000. Yeah. And the price in 6 months. In 6 months, it's maybe not 5,000, but it's already 7,000. The price of these parts. And so in the beginning he doesn't receive these parts, and but he cannot be considered as a work for free. So tax authority will take final price, or the price in 6 months, as his revenue in these 6 months. And also, I think that social fees he will pay also from this 7,000. So it will be his salary. We can consider it as his salary, because maybe it's something, some value that he get for his work. You estimate price of shares. Yeah, you estimate price of shares. Yeah. So if we give 5 parts after 6 months, after 2 years, we will give the whole company. But you don't need to continue it, and you need to preview. For example, you can make this insensitive plan in the beginning, yeah. And so during the 6 months, you will give 5 parts of the company to this person, and maybe he will believe in your project, you know. And as he will have already parts in this company, he will be motivated to develop it. And if he will work, so it's good to motivate people. Personally, I'm given, I plan to give to one colleague who is really motivated, who will help me a lot. I plan to give him some parts of my company, because I hope that it will motivate him, and he will stay with me for a long time. Yeah. So this next question. My Swiss friend hired an employee who was foreign student in EPFL. He paid salary for half a year, and after that he received the penalty from Canton near 5 years for not asking permission to hire a student. Is it legal? Yeah, because you know, for students it's also special, because you cannot hire, you can, for example, students who come to Switzerland, they cannot work at all during first six months that they are coming. After this first 6 months, they can start to work, but only on 30%. It makes 30%. It's there are 42 hours by standard in week, and if you divide it by 3, it's 40 hours in week. So you can, students, they can work only 40 hours in week, and plus they need to make a request, they need to obtain a authorization, get plus authorization needed. So you need to request for it. The special procedure, you need to fill in some forms and to request for it, then you need to wait for maybe 2 weeks or maybe 1 month for the authorization. And sorry, I didn't understand. Person who got shares, he need to pay taxes. Of course he need to pay taxes, because it's his revenue. So he gets some shares, and if shares have some price, he will pay taxes from this. And he need to declare it also in the end of this year as his fortune. Shares is a fortune, and when you get shares, you realize some revenue. Yeah. So, please let me know if you have last questions, because it's relatively hard to speak during 1 hour and 30. And I need to have some rest. So, I'm waiting for the last questions. Yeah, and the international taxation, because we did not abort this subject today, I proposed it. I proposed to postpone it. No, I proposed it to abort it later, maybe in 1 month. Let's make maybe a webinar each month. So, and it would be great if people who are interested, they will ask their questions in advance so that I will prepare the subject. No question, perfect. Is there any system for simplifying taxation for startup? Yeah, there are a lot of instruments that help startups. For example, for sure, 1 year ago there was a system that was gave an opportunity for startups not to pay taxes at all in the beginning. Yeah, I don't know if it's still actual, but 1 year ago there was an opportunity not to pay taxes or to pay reduced taxes in the first year or first few years of the activity, under conditions that the activity is useful for the local authorities. And also there are a lot of other encouragement instruments, and I propose to consult the name of this association? It's Promotion Économique. Yeah, like Promotion Économique. Yeah, try to contact them, and I think that they will tell you all of encouragements that exist now. Thank you for the useful tips and web links. Yeah, you are welcome. I really appreciate it that you was with me today, and I like to be useful to people. So if you have other questions, we can repeat this next month. What has rights for tax vacancies? Who has rights for tax vacancies? Holidays. So Lena, please, could you tell me what do you mean by tax vacancies? Tax vacancies. So I will treat next question. Is there any preferred period for creating the company and applying for the residence permit? Yes, I think that it's better to apply maybe not in the beginning of the year, but in the end of the year, because the treatment takes 6 months, something like this. So just to take in account the delays that can be applied for this treatment. So maybe in the beginning year, maybe personally I would apply. I would apply as soon as I have the dossier. So it's not so important, I think. Just try not to, even if you apply in the end of the year, you will get it next year. Yeah, if you have a good dossier, you will get a short-term residence permit in the beginning that will be converted to the normal residence permit as soon as the canton have enough places for you. So next question, tax vacancies, send your residence first. Okay, I just have who has rights for vacations? So I cannot understand this question. I will take the next one. Thanks. I saw send you already answered. Thank you for the time and information. Promotion, is there any? Yeah. Tax vacance. I don't know what is it truly. Tax vacancies. We'll just check on internet. Ampour vacance declaration. Ampour vacance. No, I cannot get it. Lena Goro. Lena, could you please tell what is it? Lena. What is tax vacations? So where did you get it? Okay. Zero taxes for startups in area of... Yes, yes, it's possible. I think 1 year ago it was possible. And I think, you know, they are making a reform now, and there was a votation, if I can tell like this. Votation. There was a voting. Maybe it was already in the beginning of this month, or maybe in they will vote in few weeks. But there was a voting to abolish all these special instruments that allow to get no taxes in the beginning, and low taxes for the companies that make their revenue abroad and so on. But I can check it. You can just send me an email, and I will reply you for free. I think that it will not take me so much time to get this information. Okay, so I think that there are no more questions, and I can have my rest. And don't hesitate to contact us if you have any legal issues, or you need just maybe a legal consultation. Also on the website on innermind.com we have some contracts that you can use, for example, for you have no disclosure agreements, you have other contracts. If you need some other contracts, don't hesitate to contact us, or maybe to write to InnoMind so that they will request it to us, and we'll update it, we'll upload it to their platform. Okay, thank you very much for your attention. I will switch off now my camera. Okay, for me it's a pleasure to hear you.
Thank you.